Hi students, how are you all? Hope all are fine and safe at your home. Be healthy and be safe. In the last class, we have started a new chapter, the chapter 9. Chapter name is Area and Perimeter, and this is our last chapter. So we have studied how to open Area Builder. The application we are using in this chapter is called Area Builder, and we have studied how to open Area Builder, and also we must know two concepts in mathematics. The first one is how to find the area of rectangle. That is, the area of rectangle is equal to length into breadth. And also the second concept, the perimeter of the rectangle. Perimeter of the rectangle is nothing but we have to add the four sides of a rectangle. Or you can use the formula 2 into length plus 2 into breadth. And we have studied when you open the software, you can see two options. One is explore and the second one is game. So when we click on explore, you can see a window like this with grids. And if you want to hide the grid, you can untick this tick mark. If you want to show the grid, you can tick here again. And this green icon, if you tick this, it will show the measurements. So from this ball, I have placed one square. If I want to know the measurements of this square, what I have to do? I have to tick here. Then I can know the measurements. The four sides are having 1 centimeter each. If I place one more, it will automatically change. Okay, so these are the two tools which we have studied, and here you can see a bowl. That bowl consists of squares. You can take the square from here, click and drag and place it here. So you can see here the measurements. And also automatically you can see the area and perimeter in this box. Area is 1. That is length into breadth. 1 into 1, 1. And here you can see perimeter is 4. How you can add the 4 sides. 1 plus 1 plus 1 plus 1, 4. And if you want to erase this square, what you have to do, you can use this yellow color button, erase button. Okay, now you can see a button here. This is a switch on button. If you click on this, what will happen? You can see two grids. So you can choose here the squares. Here also you can choose the squares, and you can compare the rectangles or squares here. So here area is 2 and perimeter is 6. Here area is 1 and perimeter is 4. So you can compare the rectangles or squares. Okay, so if you again switch off this one, it will be normal. Okay, so these are the things which we have to study in this chapter. Next, I am going to give you an extra information in this chapter. So that is game. So here at the bottom you can see game, or you can click on this home, then you can see here game. Click on game option. So there are so many levels. There are 6 levels here. You can choose any level. I will show you one level. This is not in our syllabus. This is an extra information for you. So click on the first level. Here they have given a question. What is our goal? You have built a rectangle with an area 20. That is our goal. That is the question there. I repeat, what is our question or what is our goal? We need to build a rectangle with area 20. So how to do that? So I need grids. If you need the grids, you can tick here. If you need the measurements, you can tick here. Now I am going to create a rectangle with area 20. So I am going to place these four sides here. Now what is area? 2 into 2, 4. But I need to build a rectangle with area 20. So I am going to place again. Now what is the area of this rectangle? 4 into 2, 8 only. So now I am going to place two more squares. Okay, now what is area? 4 into 4, 16 only. Okay, now I am going to place a single one here. Now what is area? 5 into 4, 20. Now it is correct. So let us check. So here you can see a button called check button. Click on that. Yes, so we got 2 points. Okay, likewise you can click on this next button. So what is our goal or what is the question? We need to build a rectangle with area 24. So you just pick the rectangles from this box, click and drag and place it here. We need to build a rectangle with area 24. So place it here. 4 into 2, 8 only. Again place it. 6 into 2, 12 only. Okay. So now what is area? 6 into 4, 24. 6 into 4, 24. Check it. Yes, that is correct. So it has given 2 points. Again, click on the next button. What is our area? What is our goal? We need to build a rectangle with area 8. So it's very simple. Now it is correct. Yes, 4 into 2, 8. That's correct. Now we need to, this is the other game, we need to type the area here. Here you need to type the answer. So what is the area here? Find the area. 5 into 4. 5 into 4, 20. So 20. I repeat, they have given a question like this. You need to find the area. So 5 into 4, 20. So we need to type here. And you click on check. Yes, that is correct. Here they have given 2 points. Next, you need to find the area. They have given 6 length and 3 breadth. So 6 into 3, 18. So we need to type here. So 18. We need to type 18. 1, 8. And click on check button. So that is correct. We have got 2 points. So likewise, we can play the game. There are so many interesting game, so many interesting levels in this game option. So you can play it. Okay. So these are the 2 options which we have having in the software area builder. Okay, students. So what all things we have studied? Yes, in the explore option you can see so many buttons. So this one is show or hide grid. If you untick this, it will hide the grids. If you tick this, it will show the grids. And if you want to place the squares, you can place, click and drag like this. And if you want to know the measurements, you can tick this green icon. If you untick this, it will not show the measurements. If you tick this, it will show the measurements. And if you want to erase this square, what you have to do, you need to click on this yellow button, eraser button. If you switch on this button, what will happen, you can compare the shapes like this. Okay, and you can see a home button here. Click on this, or either you can click on this game button directly, or you can click on this home button and you choose game option. Then you can see six levels. You can play the game accordingly. So hope all are clear about what we have studied in today's class. Thank you very much.